Welcome to Mondays in the Psalter. I'm Pastor Vandercook. Today, of course, you'll note is not Monday at all. It's Thursday, in fact. One of these days, I hope to get back on track doing this on Mondays. I've been traveling a lot since Easter, and I'm at a conference right now in Minnesota, and left on Tuesday, actually, and did not make my video on Monday before I left because I was busy getting some other things ready to go. Those are all just excuses, though, and we'll get back on track, hopefully, in the weeks to come. But this week, we take a look at the seventh section, section here of Psalm 119. This is Psalm 119, verses 49 through 56. Remember your word to your servant, in which you have made me hope. This is my comfort in my affliction, that your promise gives me life. The insolent utterly deride me, but I do not turn away from your law. When I think of your rules from of old, I take comfort, O Lord. A hot indignation seizes me because of the wicked who forsake your law. Your statutes have been my songs in the house of my sojourning. I remember your name in the night, O Lord, and keep your law. This blessing has fallen to me, that I have kept your precepts. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. So in this section of the psalm, the Psalter, first of all, we want to note here that verse 50, this is where you really find the gospel here. This is my comfort in my affliction, that your promise gives me life. The promise of forgiveness of sins, life, and salvation in Jesus Christ. That's the promise there. That's the promise that gives us life. And the rest of this section, and really, of course, this is a recurring theme throughout all of Psalm 119, is the joy that we have as a Christian in God's law. The joy here is that this law, it says, when I think of your rules from of old, I take comfort, O Lord. Yeah, and your statutes have been my songs in the house of my sojourning, songs of joy that we have this. And this is because we have been regenerated. We have been baptized into Christ. And now as we live the life of the baptized, we desire to keep God's law. This is God's law serving to us as a guide for how we live. And this is not a guide that we find to be accusatory. We take joy in it. We take joy in doing what God's law says. This is who we are as God's people. So throughout this you see, and in addition to that, you also have verse 52, when I think of your rules from of old, I take comfort, O Lord. This kind of draws us back to the reminder that not only do we take joy in the law of God, but also we know that those who have died in the faith before us, the saints, they have also had joy in this law. And this is a helpful reminder, of course, that as we live in a world that is filled with people that seem to be, and they are in a lot of cases, although I think the media sometimes blows this a little bit out of proportion, and the secular world wants us to believe that we are all alone as Christians, that we do not have anybody else around us. And it is perhaps true that the percentage of people in the world that are Christian versus the percentage of the people in the world that are not Christian is smaller than it used to be, perhaps. However, we have the reminder that we are not alone. You remember that Elijah, whenever he was on the run from Ahab and Jezebel, he's out in the wilderness and he cries out to God and basically says, I'm all alone here. Nobody else believes in the one true God. Nobody else believes in you, God. But Yahweh reminds him, you're not alone. There are several who have not bowed the knee to Baal yet. And so we have that same reminder. We're not alone. There are others in this world that also take comfort in God's law because they too have been regenerated in baptism, and they are children of God just as we are. And so we take comfort in that, but also we're reminded of, again, as it says here in verse 52, when I think of your rules from of old, I take comfort, O Lord. We remember the people that have gone before us that have also suffer the same indignation that seizes us because of the wicked. They've suffered through that too. So we're not alone, nor are we going down a path that has not already been trodden. And so rejoice in God's law this week. Rejoice that you, as the baptized, those for whom Christ has died, that you now can take joy in the law of God, that you can rejoice to be one of his people and to live as his people. Pray God's blessings on you the rest of this week, and hope to see you on Monday of next week.